In this video, I'm going to show you how to get started with Google Analytics 4, GA4. This is the latest version of Google Analytics, and I'll be showing you the new GA4 interface. You'll learn about some of the most important differences between Google Analytics 4 and Universal Analytics, which is the previous version. We'll walk through some key reports, setup options, and I'll also cover how you can upgrade to GA4 if you're not using it yet. Let's get started. Google Analytics 4 is designed to provide greater flexibility in the way you track the actions taking place on your website and in your app. Rather than being built around page views, Google Analytics 4 is built around a flexible event structure, where you can send all different types of information to your reports. On the right, we can see that when we send information to Universal Analytics, it needs to be classified into one of the predefined hit types. This basically means the way you send information to Universal Analytics is more limited, and in some cases, we need to squeeze extra details into these hit types, which made reporting difficult. On the left, we can see that all information is sent to GA4 as events, and these events can include any additional information you like, so it's very flexible. Since I want to get you up and running quickly in this video, we won't deep dive into GA4 events, but if you'd like to learn more, I've included links to my extra resources in the description below this video. If you've been using Google Analytics for a while, then you might be using a Universal Analytics property instead of a GA4 property. So let's take a look at the biggest differences between the two versions of Google Analytics. Google Analytics 4 gives you complete flexibility in the way you collect data. There is a range of reporting options, including ad hoc reporting to meet your needs. However, there are a limited number of pre-configured reports in Google Analytics 4. I need to highlight that GA4 does have an emphasis on reporting customization. So compared to Universal Analytics, you will find a much smaller selection of pre-configured reports. This means if you're getting started with Google Analytics, I also recommend creating a Universal Analytics property in parallel to GA4. Google Analytics 4 has automatic tracking built in. This means you can automatically track pages on your website, people clicking outbound links, downloading files, and more, and you won't need to modify your tracking code. There are some filtering options available for Google Analytics 4. This includes filtering out your own traffic so that you don't show up as a user in your reports. I expect we'll see more filtering options added in the future. You can make some limited changes to the attribution model used for your reports. I also expect to see the options expanded in the future. Cross-domain tracking is available in Google Analytics 4, and in most cases, you won't need to modify your tracking code to collect data for people traveling between your different domains. You can link Google Analytics 4 to Google Ads, although you can't link other products like Google Search Console. I'm hoping to see this option added in the future. You can store a raw copy of your data using Google BigQuery, and you can pull data into Google Data Studio and access your reports using Google's app. That's a quick summary of the current differences between Google Analytics 4 and Universal Analytics. In most cases, I recommend setting up Google Analytics 4 in parallel to Universal Analytics, especially if you're just getting started and don't have time to customize the reports in GA4. By having both types of properties set up in Google Analytics, you'll have access to the latest reports and features in GA4, while also having the benefits of the pre-configured reports in Universal Analytics. Now let's look at how you can identify what version of Google Analytics you're using. Let's head to Google Analytics. I've already logged in, and I've selected Admin on the bottom left corner. We can see there are three columns. There is the Account column on the left, then the Property column in the middle, and a View column on the right. Since there are three columns, this immediately tells us that we're looking at a Universal Analytics property. Now let's select another property. We can see there are only two columns. There is an Account column on the left, a Property column in the middle, and there is no View column on the right. This means we're now looking at a Google Analytics 4 property. If you follow these steps and you don't have a Google Analytics 4 property, then the first thing I recommend is that you keep your existing property. So if you're already tracking your website with Universal Analytics, you should keep tracking it into the existing property. You can then set up Google Analytics 4 in parallel to Universal Analytics. This is the best option since it means you can continue to use your existing reports with all of their historical data, and you can begin to use the new reports in Google Analytics 4. It's important to highlight that if you upgrade to GA4, then this does not include your historical data. It won't pull in any existing information, so you will be starting from scratch with your new GA4 property. I'll cover the steps to upgrade in a moment, but first let's take a look at the reports. Let's open Google's demo account. So we're looking at the GA4 demo property provided by Google. If you don't have a GA4 property yet, then you can also access this demo. I've included a link in the description below this video. The demo property is for the Google Merchandise Store, so an e-commerce website. And we're currently looking at the Home Report, which provides a top-level overview for the website. The report is made up of different cards, which provide quick insights for the different areas of our website. On the top left, we can see the overall number of users, new users, average engagement time, and total revenue. And we can also see the trend for each of these metrics. You also have the option of adjusting the number of days used for the card. To the right, you can see the number of users who have been on the website in the last 30 minutes, along with a minute-by-minute breakdown and their geographic location. Moving down, you'll find automated insights based on your data. This uses Google's machine learning to identify different points of interest for you to review. You'll also find cards that provide summaries about how people are finding your website, where they're geographically located, and more. The main menu in Google Analytics 4 is split into four sections. These are Reports, Explore, Advertising, and Configure. Let's select Reports. The Reports section includes all of the pre-configured reports for your property. The report snapshot is the same as the home report we just saw. Next is the real-time report. This shows you details for people who have recently been to your website. This is similar to the card we saw on the home report, so we can see the number of users in the last 30 minutes, the minute-by-minute breakdown, and the different devices they're using to view your website. The map shows us the geographic location of our users, and at the bottom we can see cards showing us users by source, by audience list, if you've created audience lists in the property, and the pages people are viewing. And we can see the events, conversions, and any user properties that have been configured. The report also lets us view what individual users are doing on our website. To view individual user behavior, we select View User Snapshot on the top right corner. We can now see details for a random user on our website. In the center, we can see the events that have been collected for the individual. And we can view another random user by using the arrows at the top of the report. We can see there are other reports listed on the left. If you have edit permission for the property, you can modify these. This includes customizing the menu and the reports included in the menu. We're looking at the default menu and reports, so we can see there is a section called Lifecycle and another called User. The acquisition reports provide details about how people are finding our website. The overview report provides a summary. There is a timeline at the top and the real-time card on the right. These aren't particularly useful, but below them we can see user and session medium, which tells us how people are finding the website. We can also see session campaign, which includes any Google Ads campaign sending traffic to our website, along with any campaign-tagged URLs we're using. I find the user acquisition and traffic acquisition reports are more useful, so let's take a look at the user acquisition report. This report includes additional metrics so we can see the medium, or how people are finding our website, on the left, along with the number of new users, engaged sessions, and other metrics. Scrolling to the right, we can see the number of conversions for each medium and the total revenue. We can also change the report. For example, we can select user medium on the left and change this to another dimension, like user source medium, which shows us more granular details about how people are finding our website. Next are the engagement reports. These reports provide details about what people are doing on our website. Let's take a look at the pages and screens report. This report tells you the pages people are viewing on your website. By default, we can see pages are presented by their page title in the report, but we can change this. So let's select page title and change this to page path. This is more like the pages report in Universal Analytics. We can see the total number of views for each of our pages, along with other metrics. If you have an e-commerce website and you've implemented the e-commerce tracking code, then you'll be able to use the e-commerce reports under monetization. And you'll also find reports for in-app purchases and publisher ads. This option lets you report on revenue if you're placing ads in your website or your app for monetization. The retention report includes cohort reporting. The demographics reports include details about your audience. This includes their geographic location and language preferences. And if you've enabled Google Signals, you'll also see age, gender, and interests for your users. Finally, the technology reports show you details about the different devices people are using to view your website. This includes operating system, device category, so desktop, mobile, or tablet, and other details. So they're the standard reports you'll find by default in the reports section of Google Analytics 4. Remember, as I mentioned previously, that these can be customized. So if you have edit permission, you can customize the reports and even the reporting menu. Now we're going to look at the Explore section, which lets you create custom reports and visualizations in GA4. Let's head back to Google Analytics. And let's select Explore. There are different types of custom reports you can create. These are presented at the top and include Freeform, which presents your data in a table, Funnel Exploration, which lets you create a funnel report, Path Exploration, for seeing how people travel through your content or complete other actions, Segment Overlap, to see if users are included in multiple segments, Cohort Exploration, to group users based on time, and User Lifetime, to see lifetime metrics for your users. Next are the advertising reports. These reports focus on attribution for your marketing channels. Let's open the model comparison report. This lets us compare two different attribution models to see how the different models would impact your conversions and revenue. For example, we could compare the last click attribution model to the time decay model to see how switching models would impact our metrics. And the conversion paths report. This shows you the touch points leading to conversions on your website, so you can see if people engage multiple times and with multiple marketing channels before converting. Next is the configure section. This groups different reporting configuration options. Events show you all of the events that have been collected into your GA4 property. And if you have edit permission, you can mark individual events as conversions, so they are counted as conversions in your reports. Then conversions, which only include events that are enabled as conversions. Audiences, for creating custom segments to use in your reports. Any audience you create can also be used for remarketing if you've linked your Google Ads account to GA4. Custom dimensions let you register and view custom information that you're collecting into GA4. And debug view, which lets you check your implementation and see your events as you're using Tag Assistant. I'm going to keep things simple for this tutorial, so I don't want to overload you with all of the different options you can configure in Google Analytics 4. So if you would like to learn more about the ways you can send custom events to GA4, how to configure conversions and other customization options, I've included links to even more tutorials in the description below this video. Okay, now let's walk through the steps to upgrade to Google Analytics 4. So let's head back to Google Analytics. Let's open my Universal Analytics property. We can see the GA4 Setup Assistant at the top of the property column. Let's select this. Since I already have a Universal Analytics property, let's select Get Started under I want to create a new Google Analytics 4 property. The Setup Wizard highlights some important things to consider, including that your new property won't contain historical data, that it will only copy the most basic settings, and that enhanced measurement will be enabled by default. Enhanced measurement will automatically track actions on your website, including clicking outbound links, watching embedded videos, downloading files, and scrolling. If you'd like to learn more about enhanced measurement, then check out my dedicated video. I've included a link in the description below. Since I'm using Google Tag Manager to add the Google Analytics tag to my website, we can see a message at the bottom of the wizard telling us that we need to install a new tag to start using Google Analytics 4. Now let's click Create Property. Our new GA4 property has now been created, so let's click the See Your GA4 Property button. And let's select Tag Installation under Collection. You'll now see the data stream that the GA4 Setup Assistant automatically created. You can think of a data stream as the equivalent of the tracking code you're given for each of your Universal Analytics properties. Now let's select the data stream. This opens the Web Stream Details window. On the top right corner of this window, we can see the Measurement ID, which is the equivalent of the tracking ID you'll find in your Universal Analytics property. Let's copy this. Now let's head to Google Tag Manager. Let's select the option to create a new tag. Let's name the tag. I'm going to name my tag Google Analytics GA4, but you can name it anything you like. Let's select Tag Configuration and choose GA4 Configuration as the tag type. Now we need to paste the measurement ID we copied from Google Analytics into our new GA4 tag configuration. And let's select Triggering to add a trigger to our tag. Let's select the All Pages trigger. This will add your GA4 tag to every page on your website. Now we need to save the tag. Since our new tag uses the All Pages trigger and we haven't made any customizations, I'm going to publish the tag to my website. However, if you want to preview your tags before they're published, you can click the Preview button. This will load Tag Assistant. If you would like to learn more about Google Tag Manager, including Tag Assistant, then you can find links to my Google Tag Manager tutorials in the description below this video. Okay, so I'm going to click Submit to publish the changes. And I'm going to name the version so I know that I added GA4 to my website. Once your tag is published, your new GA4 property will begin to collect data. So that's how you can get started with Google Analytics 4. If you're already using a Universal Analytics property to track your website, then I recommend you continue tracking your website into that existing property. You can then set up a new Google Analytics 4 property and track your website into both types of properties at the same time. This gives you the best of both. You can continue to use your existing reports while you also have access to the new reports and features. Are you using Google Analytics 4? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you in the next video.